Hi, everybody. Happy Monday. Hope you had a wonderful 3-day weekend and you enjoyed your Friday day off. I don't know if you can tell, but I am currently at my parents' house, aka where I grew up in Carroll Stream, which is super close to Glenbard North. So yeah, I'm here for the day. And because I was here for the day, I thought I'd make this video kind of funny for you. So I included trivia with Spike throughout. So enjoy. All right, today we are talking about analyzing scatter plots. I am pumped that we had enough time to cover this before you graduated and moved on to high school because it's such a critical skill for both next year's math and science classes. So let's jump in and let's get going. All right. Your objective for today, my computer ever loads, is that you can analyze scatter plots and draw conclusions based on the data. When we're analyzing scatter plots, here's a really quick acronym that you can use just to make sure that you cover like all elements of that conclusion. So we can talk about association type, outliers, and conclusion. That satisfies the acronym AOC. So association type, that means positive, negative, or none. Outliers, you would just tell me, do you see any data points that are like far away from your clustered points or no? And then your conclusion is just a concise statement that you make that includes both variables. So AOC, that is the acronym we can use to help us analyze scatter plots. Let's go through a few examples. Okay, here is example number one. Notice that this graph is comparing dog height versus dog weight. So let's use the acronym AOC to help us analyze the scatter plot. And let me grab my highlighter and then we will get going. Okay, ask yourself, is this a positive, negative, or no association? Well, I see that as this trend line is going up, it has a positive slope, so this definitely has to be a positive association. In terms of outliers, to me, there's only one obvious outlier, and I would say that that's right here. And we could also write that as a coordinate pair for the outlier. It would be 27. Oh my goodness gracious. I need a pen. All right, so it would be 27, and then it would be 112. So if I was talking about the outlier, I'd say yes, there is one, and then here is the coordinate pair for that. Okay, last part, most important part. To draw a conclusion about the scatter plot, you just need to make a statement that summarizes what's going on with the data, and it includes both variables. Well, I see that as the dog height is going up, the weight is also increasing, which makes sense because, like, think about like a Chihuahua, how little that is and how light it is compared to like a German Shepherd or a Saint Bernard. So obviously we know that for dogs, as their height increases, their weight also increases. This is what I would type out as my formal conclusion. All right, here we go. It is time for trivia round one. Okay. How cute he is. Okay, here we go. Spike, who's the better rapper, Lil Baby or Drake? Okay, go ahead. What a traitor! He chose Lil Baby.
I was not happy about that one, I'm not gonna lie. I was very upset that he chose that, but whatever. Okay. Example number two. Here we go. So here's a graph that we're looking at. So this is talking about Mr. Patel's TikTok life and his involvement on the TikTok app. So notice that down here we're looking at the number of TikToks that he posts compared to the number of followers that he has. So let's use our acronym AOC to help kind of analyze this and go over it. So step one, what type of association do you see? I mean, to me, it looks pretty clear that that's like a negative association because it's going down. The slope of your trend line is negative. I don't see any outliers here. There's no points that are like here or here or here. So I'm going to go with no outliers. Here's the most important part, your conclusion. What do you notice as he posts more TikToks? What do you notice about his number of followers? Well, I can tell that the more TikToks that he posts, the number of followers that he has decreases, aka as more people start to watch his videos, they start to unfollow him. Guys, that's kind of embarrassing. Okay, so here's the statement that I typed out. As the number of TikToks Mr. Patel posts increases, Okay, that's down here. The number of his followers decreases. And there's two other ways that you can say that. You could say when Mr. Patel posts more TikTok videos, he loses followers. You could also say the more TikTok videos that Mr. Patel posts, the fewer followers he has. What you need to know is that as this variable is increasing, this one is decreasing for Mr. Patel. And here, that brings me to trivia round two. How appropriate. All right, here we go.
Who does the savage TikTok better, Mr. Patel or Mr. Battaglia? Okay, go ahead, Spike. He chose Mr. Battaglia and Mr. Patel.
Okay, so clearly Mr. Battaglia is practicing his savage TikTok at home. Spike showed us that that is true. So, poor Mr. Battaglia and poor Mr. Patel. Okay, here we go. Last example. Okay, so example number three, we're looking at the number of siblings versus a grade. Okay, so that's like the number of siblings that you have versus your grade in math class. Step one, what type of association do you see? Well, I personally see that the data points are everywhere on your scatter plot. So that's going to be a no association. There is no association there. They're not going up, they're not going down. Outliers, you can't really tell because the data points are literally everywhere, okay? But if you had one that was like maybe like right out here, that you could say is an outlier. But for this graph, no, no outliers. Then for the conclusion, and you need to include both variables. You guys, if there's no association, then you can just say there's no association between the grade that you get and the number of siblings you have. I have one sibling, and that doesn't determine that I get an A in math or a D in science, okay? They have no effect on one another. So you could say the number of siblings you have has no effect on your class grade. You could also say there's just no association between the number of siblings you have and your grade. Any of those work. All right, trivia round three. Here we go, last one. Here we go.
Okay, Spike, who's better at 2K, Mrs. LeBan or Jose? Okay, go ahead. That's right. Mrs. LeBan is better at 2K. Good job.
That's right. So let the record be known that I am better at 2K. I've been practicing for weeks. So there you go. Okay, so here's your assignment for today. You have a very quick Schoology check, and you're going to be analyzing the scatter plots from the data you guys gave me last week on Thursday. Remember that Google form you filled out? Yeah, I used that data to create your assignment for today. Cool, I know. So go ahead, please get that done by 11:59. Submit for me, and then you are done for today. Have a beautiful day. Enjoy the sunshine, and I will see you later. Bye-bye.